we need to learn the principles behind good architecture. So the solid principles, there's also command query separation, composite reuse, functional core, imperative shell, tell, don't ask. Everything is related.
Yes.
We need to use them in combination.
Yeah.
Because one supports the other. Like all those principles, they also apply to functions. As we said, one of the principles here, functional core, imperative shell, right? You can have the core of your application functional. Pure functions, pure values.
Stateless.
Yes. Performing operations on data, pure data, no mutation, no global state.
Yes, makes sense.
And to support the design principles, we have design patterns.
Yes.
So adapter, decorator, composite, strategy, proxy, delegate, even MVC, MVVM, MVP in the UI side, you know, dependency injection.
Yes.
All those patterns help you support a clean architecture. So you don't need to put all the code in one single class. And finally, we have practices like use case analysis, domain modeling, domain-driven design, behavior-driven development, test-driven development, pairing, you know, mod programming. The more you share knowledge, the more you learn, the more you're going to improve the architecture because you're going to know more about the challenge. You're going to know more about the domain and you keep iterating because you're not going to get the perfect architecture in the first try.
Yes.
As the product changes, the architecture needs to change. So you need design and you're going to have to make architectural decisions in the beginning.
Yes.
But it should be extendable. You should be able to evolve the design as you go because in the long term, things are going to change a lot. So we cannot predict the future, but we can allow the system to be extendable